back to my channel. We are adjacent to my kitchen island, and I are best friends because it's super stable, reliable, and it never leaves me because it's like, you know, attached to the floor. Is it attached to the floor?
Yeah.
How do you build a kitchen island? That's a really good question. I am so excited for today's baking video because not only is this one of my favorite cakes that I've made, it's one of my favorite people. Everyone's favorite Degrassi castmate, Aislinn Paul. She's behind the camera. Woo-hoo! So a lot of you guys are commenting on my Instagram picture that I posted of her birthday cake, asking if I had shot a video, and la-duh, obviously we shot a video, and welcome to that video. You are here, you've arrived, congratulations, I'm so happy for you. I can't wait to show you guys this cake, to give you a brief little overview. I'm sure you were intrigued by the thumbnail, hopefully. It is a chocolate raspberry cheesecake cake. Does that sound redundant? Kind of. Is it? Not really. Maybe? No, not really. Before I get started in the video, if you guys want to know any of the exact specific measurements and all that stuff, if you're going to make this cake, I'm gonna have it all listed on my blog, so I'll have the link down below. So the cake layers for this cake are chocolate cake. But I already showed you guys how to do that in my mocha chocolate cake video, and wow, this footage looks exactly the same. That's because it is. If you want super detailed instructions on how to make my favorite chocolate cake recipe, you guys can check out that video. I'll have it linked down below as well. I just didn't want to film it twice. So yeah. I also mentioned it in that video, but once my cake layers are done being baked and stuff and they're cool, I like to wrap them in saran wrap and then put them in freezer safe Ziploc bags and place them in the freezer. Just getting chilled so they're easier to, you know, do all that stuff. So we're gonna start with the cheesecake. Woo! So in my stand mixer, I started with my room temperature cream cheese and I started whipping that up. You definitely want it to be room temperature because do you know how hard cream cheese is? You've seen them try and spread that on your bagel and you're like, it's not gonna work. And once it started to whip up and you can see that it's really smooth, now I slowly added in my sugar a little bit at a time, making sure it was fully incorporated before I added more. After the cream cheese and the sugar are all combined, then I added in my egg and then the sour cream and then vanilla and then a little bit of flour. So once that's all thoroughly combined into my prepared springform pan, and I placed it in technically considered a cake pan, but it's more rectangular and it's a little deeper. You're basically baking it in a water bath, which helps make sure this cheesecake doesn't crack. But honestly, who fucking cares if it cracks? It's going in the middle of a goddamn cake. And if people are like, oh, your cheesecake, oh wow, it cracked. You're like, you're eating a cake with cheesecake in the middle and this is not the Cheesecake Factory. Do you know how lucky you are? Don't complain. I also don't show this in the video, which I wish I did, but I went back in and added tin foil at the bottom of the springform pan just to prevent any water getting into it because that would just completely ruin it and I did not want to make another one. So while that's baking off in the oven, I moved on to my raspberry filling. You could totally use store-bought, but yes, I definitely will judge you and so will Ina Garten. So I just took frozen raspberries, added in some sugar, some cornstarch, and some lemon juice and just cooked that until it started to get really nice and lovely and thick. This is also the point if you're like, well, Megan, I don't really love raspberries. Or, Megan, can I do this with strawberries? Can I do this with blackberries? Faux shizzle, home dog, you can. Just make a different fruit compote and then you're able to use that for the rest of the cake. See? Unagi. Won't lie to you guys, making this raspberry filling was definitely the most time-consuming process of this whole cake, and I'm including decorating. Once you're all done and it's thick, you think your job's over, it's not. You wanna cool it a little bit or enough that you're able to handle it without being like, wow, I'm gonna get burns all over my body. Then we're gonna strain it because nobody wants seeds in their cake. Seeds out, I'm going to set that aside to cool and move on to the Swiss meringue buttercream. Congratulations, people of Switzerland, you have a delicious, delicious buttercream. So I use the method of making Swiss meringue where I start with my egg whites and my sugar over heat, like a double boiler, and I continue to stir that until it reaches 160 degrees Fahrenheit. Yes, your arms are gonna get tired. They're gonna get very tired. You're gonna have to phone a friend in, you're gonna have to switch arms, maybe get your boyfriend to do it. He probably has some experience, just stamina with his arm. The good thing is that that joke, if you're very young, you're not gonna get it at all. But if you're like, if you have a cool, love it, awesome, nice. So once that has reached 160 degrees Fahrenheit, I'm pouring that into my stand mixer. Oh, I didn't even put my other shit in the stand mixer. I just put it in a bowl, whatever. And with the whisk attachment, I am just going to beat that. Beat it real good. You wanna wait until the bowl is cool to the touch. Right now it feels very hot. Can you see that bug, guys? So a good rule of thumb is once the bowl starts to feel cooler to the touch, that's when you'll know that it's starting to get ready to move on to the next step. And then you'll also be able to see that this is when your meringue is building these like very stiff, glossy, absolutely beautiful peaks. That's how you know it's time to add your butter in. I won't lie to you guys, it's a lot of butter. But it's all room temperature and I sliced and diced it up into these little cubes. So taking a couple little cubes at a time, I'm just like chucking them into the mixer while it's on and making sure that it fully incorporates that butter before I add more butter in. This is going to ensure that your Swiss meringue buttercream is very, very, very smooth and doesn't have any like, you know, weird buttery pockets where you're like, oh, this is so good. Oh, why does this taste like something that should be on garlic bread? Once that's fully combined, I am going to take my cooled raspberry filling and add a little bit at a time into my buttercream until it gets to be a pink color that I like. So as soon as you have the pink color that you like with it, you're solid. Then I'm taking a smaller bit of said buttercream and adding even more raspberry filling to that to make it a darker pink color. Now I've got two colors of pink buttercream. Next, I moved on to making my ganache. It's incredibly simple. It's just chocolate and heavy whipping cream. Again, I'll have the specific measurements on my blog, but you wanna essentially heat up your heavy whipping cream before it starts to boil, before it starts to like, you know, start evaporating, because science, heat, all that stuff, where it's pretty warm, and then pour that on top of your chocolate. Set it aside for like a minute, 2 minutes, and then stir it, and all the chocolate is going to melt, and it looks like the opening credits of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. And you're like, ooh, it becomes very sensual, very sexual. Guys, we have reached the most amazing portion of this whole video, the decorating portion. So I've already leveled my chocolate cakes, basically just making sure that they're all the same, you know, same size. We don't want any, you know, sorry Fergie, lady humps on the top or manly humps. And now I'm a stacking on up. So I just use a little cake board, adhere a little bit of buttercream to the bottom and attach that to my rotating marble cake stand. So starting with a chocolate layer, I placed that on top of the cake board and then I filled up a absolutely massive, massive piping bag with the light pink raspberry buttercream. And I made sure to kind of create like a, I don't know, like looks kind of like a pool, like a bathtub where it has a lip that's higher on the sides, because we're going to be adding the raspberry compote as well as the chocolate ganache there. So you want to make sure that there's like a frosting kind of barrier on either side so you, it doesn't just like pour and slip out. Sensual seduction, so I can get a sensual seduction. Then on top of that, I'm going to add the cheesecake layer. Sometimes cheesecake, if it's like in the fridge and stuff, it can do this thing that is actually a technical term when it comes to food called sweating. So if you feel like it's a little slippery or a little too slick, you can totally dry it off with a paper towel, which is what I did, which is usually like what I do, like under my armpits. And then to that, I'm also going to do the same thing with the buttercream and then the raspberry compote and then the chocolate. Now when you're putting on the layers on top of the other layers, don't press super hard, because like, yeah, we've created kind of a little barrier of frosting on either side so they don't, the fillings don't really explode. But I mean, they're just like gently resting, so don't fuck with it too hard. I'm adding on the final chocolate layer, and then this is when I go on to my crumb coat. So especially because we have a chocolate cake with a very light buttercream, a crumb coat is really important, because guess what it does? It sticks all your crumbs inside that first layer of buttercream. So get a really thin layer. I'm sure Yolanda from How to Cake It has already taught you guys about crumb coating and chilling. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna crumb coat it and then we're going to place it in the fridge for like half an hour, or if you wanna just test the cake, touch it, and if you don't get any buttercream off on your finger and it's kind of like, you know, cool to the touch, feels a little more smooth, that's when you're ready to come back and do a second layer. Because it's not fondant, it's not going to have that absolutely impeccable, perfect, smooth sides. But I tried my goddamn hardest. Really fucking tried, guys. It's not even my birthday. fitted a new piping bag. And this time it's got like, I think it's called a French tip. All I know is it's my favorite piping tip. Like if I were to rank them, this would definitely be number one. And now I'm adding on the cute little like, little things on top of the cake. Go on to the little beep beep bloop 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 parts right now. Do the ganache drips first.
So seductive. I take you to the candy shop. I let you lick the lollipop. Go ahead, girl, don't you stop. Keep going till you hit the spot. Whoa.
I'll take you to the candy shop.
Yeah.
One more taste of what I got.
Uh huh.
I'll have you spending all you got.
Come on.
Keep going till you hit the spot.
Whoa. This is not what I did, but what I would do is pop that into the fridge then, and then once the ganache had set, then go on and do the frosting piping on top. But hey, you win some, you lose some. You brain fart, you really fart. So I added a couple more of my little like bloobity bloop 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 things because they're super, super cute. And then I popped the cake in the fridge again. You don't really see this because you know, it's a movie. It's not a movie, it's a fucking YouTube video. God damn it, Megan.
No, I like it, aim high, aim high.
It's a feature length film. Who's doing the score?
You put it in Letterbox.
This summer, a cake so delicious. Wow, guys, we've made it to the morning of the cake being served. Woo-hoo! And this is when I added on little raspberries on the top. And I wait to do this just honestly right before the cake was served, just because raspberries or any fruit in general, you know, they're very pretty and they're very cute, but like the longer they sit out, they kind of, you know, they bleed and they like drip and they ooze and they get a little like soggy and not so cute. So I wanted to wait until the last minute and then also on the bottom of the cake stand. Oh, we forgot to put candles on your cake. Forgot
about it. You have to do it again.
No. No. And that's it. The cake is done. Now to you, Megan, where you're gonna slice it.
Wow, I look fucking great. Shall we cut the cake?
Wait, what? You're not gonna do a little intro of what you're doing? And then I'll come in and shoot
the
cutting of the cake.
So the cake is officially done. It looks cute as fuck. Oh, I wish I gave you this job. So much pressure. Okay, I don't know how to get out of here. Come on. Oh my god. Holy shit.
Leo slice.
I've been so excited.
It looks like a Cheesecake Factory cake. And like a compliment to my girlfriend.
This is like my dream cake.
The inside looks
pretty
excited.
Too.
Yeah?
It's so good!
Woo!
I'm so happy!
Happy birthday, Aislinn. As a wonderful birthday present to her, guys, you guys should all follow her on Instagram and Twitter and IMDb. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, leave comments, do those things. The recipe's on the blog, and yeah. How else do I envy? That's good. Leo Hard Brazil is gonna be all up on this shit.
That's just your thumbnail as you have in the whole thing.
Fuck yeah!
And we all exit frame. Okay, bye.
Gosh, Megan, Aislinn, and Leo, that was so funny and entertaining. Did I do an outro already in that? Maybe. Whoa, it's an outro after the outro. Redundant. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and comment down below what your dream birthday cake is, because I kind of want to get better at making layer cakes and doing other treats and things like that. So maybe it's not even a cake. Maybe it's something else. But I would really like to know your dream cake flavor. Maybe it's like Fruit Loops cake, like something nobody's done yet. Really like to try that. Not that nobody's done that yet, because I mean, everybody's done something, but like nothing I've done yet. And if you guys, again, want to check out the full recipe, it's up on the blog, which will be linked down below, along with like the tools and stuff that I used. And also in the description bar, you can find my socials, my handles, follow me on the Instagram, and you'll also see my friends who are in this video, also known as Birthday Girl Aislinn Paul. You can check out her stuff too down there. Hope you guys liked it, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.